Hello students, welcome back to my channel Biomania. I am your biology teacher and once again I am here to teach you fabulous topics. In this video we will study about Mendel's laws of inheritance, which we are following till date, as I have told you in earlier video also. And Mendel has given us three laws. The first law is the law of dominance. The second law is the law of segregation, which is also known as the law of purity of gametes. In previous videos you can learn these two laws, and in this video we are going to learn especially the law of independent assortment, that is the third law of Mendel. Very crucial, very important and very logical law it is. So watch this video completely and very carefully, and also note down all the important points so that you will retain all the things very well. Are you ready for this journey, right guys? Okay. Yeah, before understanding the law of independent assortment, we have to learn about the dihybrid cross, because we cannot study law of independent assortment without knowing the dihybrid cross. But in case of law of dominance and law of segregation, it can be learned with the help of monohybrid and dihybrid both. So first we will see what is the dihybrid cross, and after that we will see how it is related with the independent assortment. Are you ready? Okay, so let's start. As Mendel told us to always start with the pure line, so parent should be always pure lines, and it is the dihybrid cross. So here we are taking both alleles, that is the capital T which represent the tall character, and that is the capital P, and capital P that is for the color one. So there are two traits which are present here, and both are the dominant traits and they are completely pure lines. So what generation it is? It is actually the parent generation. So these are the parents. Okay, I am writing P for parents. And here you can see all the recessive one, lowercase t, lowercase t and lowercase p and lowercase p. So first we will see that how the gamete will form. As we all know that how the gamete will form, for this one it will form like this t will go with that p. So what will form? TP. And that T is also go with the that P, TP. So all four gametes which will form are the same here, and in that case that is like that. So let's have a look about that also. Here you can see that these are the gametes. And what will form here? We will see here that generation will known as the F1 generation, progenies. Okay, so when it will cross with that, then what it will form? This one and this one I am crossing. So that is capital T, that is lowercase t, that is capital P, and that is the lowercase p. In that case, that is also same, that is capital T, lowercase t, capital P and lowercase p, that is a capital P. So here you can see it easily in that manner. So all 16 kinds of progeny are having the same kind of genotype, that is the capital T, lowercase t, capital P and the lowercase p. So their genotype will be the same. That is the actual F1 generation which we got here. Now when the selfing will occur between the F1 generation progenies, after that we will get the F2 generation. And during that cross, we will see that how it is independently assorting themselves, or you can say during the gamete formation you can see that how they are independently assorting themselves with each other. Before the selfing of them, let's have a look about their gamete formation. So how it will occur, let's have a look about that. Here you can see that this is the F1 generation progenies, this is also. And now here the selfing is going between them. Now when the selfing will go, then what will form in the form of gamete? That particular capital T will go with independently, they will go independently with that capital P, and that cap, it means what will form, I am writing here, that capital T will go with the capital P, that capital T will also go with the lowercase p, and that small t also go with the capital P, and that small t also go with the lowercase p. It doesn't matter if it is forming the gamete with that capital P, that it doesn't matter that what is present here. If it is recessive, then it doesn't matter for them. And same for this one also, what is present here, it doesn't matter. What same for them also, what is present in their next side, that doesn't matter. They are independently going with the another trait's allele. It means that is a single trait capital T for the tall trait, and that is independently going with the purple color, and that is also independently going with the white color trait. Same for the recessive allele, which is for the shortness, and that is independently going for the purple color, and that short allele, recessive allele, is also going with the same, independently going with the white color allele. So what kind of gamete will form here, we can see here. Yeah, this is the, as I have written here, capital T, capital P, T, lowercase p, same here and same here. And when for the next one, that is also same. So it means if we see it in the form of definition, then it means alleles of one trait. Alleles of one trait segregate independently from alleles with allele of another trait. It doesn't matter what kind of recessive allele or what kind of dominant allele is present next to them. It doesn't matter completely. So they are forming the trait very clearly. So that is the Mendel's law of independent assortment, because here the all alleles are independently assorting them with other alleles, or with other alleles, or you can say with the alleles of other traits. So that is the law of independent assortment. Now I think this law is also clear to you. After that, we will study in the next videos, that is the monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, and okay. So watch all these videos, and for getting all the updates, you have to subscribe my channel. And if you like the video, don't forget to press the like button and also share with your friends so that they will get also benefit of it. So guys, thank you for watching my video. Bye-bye this time.